position those rifles were in. What if there'd been an emergency?
Yes, well, thought had occurred to me.
Mrs. Davidson means well, but she's too soft. They're forever taking advantage of her.
She's got a lot on her mind at the moment.
And whose fault's that? It's not as if she hasn't been told.
Yes, I know, but I think we should just let up on her for a bit.
Well, don't think I'm standing up for Gillespie. He seems to be rather down on me in particular. But it's a pity we can't have someone like him for governor. This place had run like clockwork.
Oh, we could also be in for some trouble. Lots of it.
Well, if Gillespie was governor instead of Mrs. Davidson, well, we'd be prepared for trouble whenever it happened.
And one step out of line and we'd be on the carpet.
So, that's the way a prison should be run. I'm telling you, Gillespie's the kind of governor this place needs.
Would you just mind explaining where you got that little lot? All right, you bitch. Now, what do you think you're up to?
Now, hang on, B. It's not what you think.
You're going to have to work bloody hard to convince me.
That money was planted in here.
Nice try.
Damn it, I'm telling you the truth. I was set up. I'm as much in the dark about this as you are.
Well, a hell of a lot of people, me included, are going to find your story pretty hard to swallow. I had a sneaking suspicion you were trying to finance an escape.
Well, maybe I am, but I wouldn't steal from my mates.
You didn't mind taking it from Nolene Burke last time you wanted to get out.
Nolene Burke is a different kettle of fish, and you know it. Now, I don't care what you believe, because I'm telling you the truth. I was set up. That money was planted in here.
Well, just suppose I do take your word for it. Who would want to do that?
Well, how the hell would I know that? I've no idea who. I have no idea why. All I know is that I'm not taking the blame for it, because that money has gone straight back to where it came from.
They're going to love your story.
Tough, it's the truth.
All right. As long as you return, everyone gets their money back, I suppose it's all right. But I'd certainly like to know what's going on around
you
here.
You and me both.
You know, I have the distinct impression someone's trying to stir up trouble.
Yeah, but who?
I don't know. But whoever it is, they're doing a bloody good job of it.
Yeah.
I think it might have something to do with this new bloke, Gillespie.
But that doesn't make sense. Why?
Maybe that's how he gets his kicks. You think about it, though. Ever since he's been here, he's brought in so much security you can hardly move. Everyone's at each other's throats. I've never seen so much friction in the joint.
Well, what would he get out of it?
Oh, I don't know. You know, I feel as if someone's trying to push me into doing something to give an excuse to have me transferred or something.
Oh, come on, B. That doesn't make sense either.
Maybe. They've never needed an excuse before.
Well, look, come on. Doesn't make sense, my girl, because if you were going to be transferred, wouldn't it be simpler for them to just go ahead and do it?
I'll tell you one thing. I'm not going to give them an excuse.
Come on, let's go and eat dinner. I want to give this back.
Mm.
Look, let's not worry too much about it, huh? Because whoever is responsible for this, sooner or later, they're going to overplay their hand.
Well, let's just hope it's sooner, eh?
What is it?
I don't know. I don't cook it. I don't serve it. Mm, bombs.
Eh? Well, look at all the screws. I reckon there's bombs in this club. Hey, Lizzie, guess what?
I don't know.
Go and get your dinner.
I'll get it in a minute, but guess what I heard?
I told you I don't know.
Oh, God, this stuff stinks.
Davo's getting the boot.
What?
Shh. Dinky die. Vinegar Tits was telling Fletch all about it, and it's true.
Who's gonna take her place?
Well, that's the thing, see?
Well, who is?
Shh.
Why so many screws? That's what I was wondering. You better hang on to the money till later.
What do you call that cack?
I'd call it unfit for human consumption. Listen, why does everyone bitch at me? I didn't buy it. I didn't cook it.
Oh, what am I socking it, Margot?
Wouldn't make much difference if I did. Aren't you eating?
Oh, I'll get some in a minute.
Yeah, I wouldn't bother.
Mm. Are you going to tell them about the money or am
I? No,
I
will.
What's going on?
Well, somebody planted that money in my cell.
Oh, pull the other one. I've heard that song before. That isn't true, is it, Ben?
Well, I think it is. I think someone's playing funny buggers.
Yeah, well, you can say that again after the news I heard.
Yeah.
Oh, stress. Well, what is it?
Well, they're going to give Davo the bullet.
Who is?
Them, the department. They're going to give the job to that bloke Gillespie.
Are you sure?
Yeah, Vera and Fletch were talking about it.
Oh, there you are. That's what we were talking about. That's what Gillespie gets out of pushing us around.
Yeah, well, I reckon it's all wrong. Mrs. Davidson's always done the right thing by us. And that bloody Gillespie, he's worse than Vera.
Well, I don't like the way things are going on around here. And I wish to hell I knew what they were up to.
Mrs. Davidson, I'd like a word with you.
Oh?
I'm afraid it can't wait. I've just been made aware of this departmental report.
Yes?
Concerning, of all things, Cinderella.
Yes, the pantomime.
Is that all you have to say about it?
What would you like me to say, Mr. Gillespie?
Why wasn't I informed?
You're behaving as though it was deliberately kept a secret from you, which I assure you it was not.
Oh, it certainly looks that way.
Mr. Gillespie, up until now you have shown absolutely no interest in the women's activities at all, apart from security matters.
As far as I'm concerned, this is a security matter.
And as far as I am concerned, it is not.
In my opinion, I'm the best judge of that. There's no alternative. It'll have to be cancelled.
That is utterly ridiculous. I have given my promise to the women, and I fully intend to keep it.
It'll be wise not to push your luck.
Mr. Gillespie, the women will perform that pantomime for the orphans, even if I have to appeal directly to the minister myself. Let me finish. For years, I have tried to develop a trusting relationship. I am not going to jeopardize that, and I'm willing to lay my job on the line over it. That show will go on.
All right, Mrs. Davidson. We know where we stand.
We do indeed.
Good night.
Well, the whole thing sounds pretty far-fetched to me.
Just be thankful you're getting your money back at all.
Oh, I am. Don't worry about that. And I don't give a damn where it came from either. But it seems to me you are getting off delightly.
And I am getting pretty sick and tired of this. How many times do you have to be told?
Well, you must admit, it don't sound too good. I mean, she tried it once before she was gonna remember from Nolan, see?
Judy and I have been through all that before.
Yes, yeah, so what?
Yeah, but if she was ready to try it, won't she be ready to try it again?
Not
right?
Necessarily.
Pig.
Give it a rest, Lizzie.
Look, the main thing is we've got our dough back.
You're wrong. The main thing is not to let it get on our nerves. Look, I still think that someone is trying to unnerve us, niggle us, get us off balance.
Who?
I don't know, Gillespie, maybe.
Gillespie? How would he know where to find the money?
Well, the money may not be connected, but there are too many other things, too many little coincidences. We've just got to keep our cool over this.
Oh, you've been watching too much television.
Okay, girls, is everyone happy? Have you all got back your money? Now, I'll give this back to Margot and the others tomorrow.
Okay, now let's get back to some kind of normality. Oh, there's nothing normal whatsoever in this joint. What do you have in mind?
Panto. Well, what's the matter?
Well, I suppose we sort of lost interest.
But what's that supposed to mean?
Well, we thought that everybody had sort of given up the whole idea.
Well, I think you deserve a good kick in the backside. God. I mean, it was your idea to do a show for the orphans, after all.
Oh, don't look at me. I just got here yesterday.
Mrs. Davidson went to a lot of trouble to get permission. Ken sent us scripts, and I think you should at least have the decency to go through with it.
Sorry I'm late, everybody. Just finishing off the rosters.
It's all right, Mr. Fletcher. Please sit down. I have a further list of recommendations from Mr. Gillespie.
Recommendations or orders?
Instructions, shall we say. Consistent with the aim of upgrading prison security, you've already had your reorientation session in firearms, it has been decided that all prison officers will be given a refresher course in unarmed combat.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Hardly ridiculous, but unnecessary, I feel.
I don't agree. Well, one never knows when one might be placed in a position of danger in this job.
Oh, I suppose it's inevitable you'd agree with Mr. Gillespie. However, I can't help feeling that I could control most of the women here if I had to.
Well, let's hope that occasion does not arise.
But suppose it does. In my opinion, we've always been far too lax in our handling of these prisoners.
I was well aware of what your opinion would be. However, all officers will undertake the course. Now, the next instruction mainly concerns you, Mr. Fletcher. The armory is to be restocked and you will be in charge of all firearms and their maintenance.
That's unbelievable. Well, it's all very well to have these talks and take these stupid refresher
There's
courses.
There's a lot of tension in the prison at the moment.
Yes, there is, and 90% of it is caused by that martinet Gillespie.
What have we had to quell a riot?
We've had riots before, Vera, and we've never had to turn the guns on them so far. We've always been capable of negotiation.
You can't rely on that.
All right, I'm not going to argue about this all day. Mr. Gillespie's final recommendation is that the pantomime should be cancelled.